Pronouns. Let us recall what we have already learnt. We might recall that pronouns are used in place of nouns. We know how they step in to help when we do not want to repeat the noun. Let us see how they work. Look at these. Lakshmi is afraid of cockroaches, but Lakshmi likes some other insects. Lakshmi likes butterflies. Lakshmi likes to study nature. Teachers and friends appreciate Lakshmi. We have said 5 things about Lakshmi and we have mentioned the name Lakshmi 5 times. It doesn't sound good, does it? So we call the pronouns and ask them, "Would you like to step in, please?" "Yes, of course," say the pronouns. Here they are. Lakshmi is afraid of cockroaches, but she likes some other insects. She likes butterflies. She likes to study nature. Teachers and friends appreciate her. These are pronouns, the words which are ready to stand in for nouns. Verbs. Looking back, we have learnt that verbs are action words or being words or words that show possession. Remember? Let us recall. Bees collect nectar. They turn nectar into honey. They have the honey in their honeycomb. Honey is good for health. We have a bottle of honey on the table. Sentences 1 and 2 have used the verbs as action words. Sentences 3 and 5 have used the verbs to show possession. And sentence 4 has used the verb as a being word. So the words collect and turn are action words. The word have shows possession. The word is a being word. We also learnt that the verbs have their singular and plural forms. They are used in agreement with the subject of the sentence, the noun. Let us take a few examples. This car is costly. These cars are costly. Here, are is the plural form of is. This child has cough. These children have cough. Here, have is the plural form of has. This policeman directs traffic. These policemen direct traffic. Here, direct is the plural form of directs. The English teacher likes me. All the teachers like me. Here, like is the plural form of likes. They are used in agreement with the subjects. Adverbs. About a verb, an adjective, or another adverb. Take a look at these sentences. Sweetie spoke softly. Our team played well. Lata sang sweetly. Sheila prayed silently. The words softly, well, sweetly, and silently say something about the verbs. They are adverbs. The word softly describes how Sweetie spoke. The word well describes how the team played. The word sweetly says how Lata sang, and the word silently says how Sheila prayed. These words which say such things about the verbs are adverbs. We have seen that adjectives describe the nouns. In the same way, adverbs describe the verbs. Let us see how it happens. In sentence 1, without the adverb softly, we can imagine any number of things of how Sweetie could have spoken. But the word softly cuts down our imagination and says specifically how she really spoke. So just like adjectives, adverbs also reduce our imagination, directing us, the listener or the reader, to a particular description. In sentences 2, 3 and 4 too, we can see the same thing happening. The word well directs us to understand the particular way they played. The word sweetly shows how exactly she sang. The word silently shows the way she prayed. All these adverbs have said something about the verb, the action word. But adverbs are not concerned with verbs alone. Take a look at this. Today I have solved a very difficult problem. Here the word problem is a noun, which is described by the adjective difficult. The word very describes the adjective difficult, saying how difficult. This is also an adverb. So we can say that adverbs may not only describe verbs, but adjectives as well. But wait a minute. We have not finished with the adverbs yet. Take a look at this. Tenzing climbed the rock quite easily. In this sentence, the word easily is an adverb because it describes the verb climbed. But there is another word describing this adverb. Do you see that? Yes, it is quite, which describes the word easily. This is also an adverb. So, what do we say? Adverbs may describe adverbs too. So, what do we have? We have adverbs that can do three different things. They can describe verbs, adjectives, and other adverbs.